Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's topic, I'll be talking about the genotype. I know at times maybe you have heard people saying, what's your genotype? Have you checked your genotype? Or when you're about getting married, or if you are dating someone, they will always request you, like, you need to do your blood group, you need to check your genotype, maybe you have to check your HIV status and whatsoever. So today I'll be explaining what it all mean by the genotype to make you understand it better. My name is Yvonne. If this is your first time watching me, don't forget to like, subscribe, and also share this video. It might equally help someone out there. So let's get into it. So when we talk about the genotype, we are mostly referring to the characteristics, you know, the characteristics that makes you unique. So that is what we mean by the genotype. At times you have the genotype, the phenotype, that will give you your physical expression. What makes you look tall, what makes you look short, what makes you have this kind of feature. So that is what the genotype is all talking about. So, but before I get into this, we need to understand, when we are talking of the genotype, we are mostly linking it with blood, that is red blood cells. And in the red blood cell, we need to know the red blood cell has different types of part, but the most important part we'll be talking about will be the hemoglobin. So let's take for example, this is our red blood cell, this is our hemoglobin, this one in the middle is the hemoglobin. So this is our hemoglobin, this is our red blood cells. So this hemoglobin, it's a small tiny structure. The function of this hemoglobin, it's red in color. It's what gives the red blood cell its red color. So the structure of this hemoglobin, the main function of it is for it to bind with oxygen and help the red blood cell to be able to transport oxygen in the body. So in the case, in a situation where the shape of this hemoglobin, or the hemoglobin, is very small, it will not be able to carry the required oxygen, or it will not be able to bind to the required quantity of oxygen. That is why in the case where you get, they say someone is sickle cell anemia, or someone has a sickle cell trait, it means this structure of this hemoglobin, it's not normal. Either it's so tiny, it's so small, or it's not having the normal shape. And if it's so tiny, if it's so small, if it's not having the normal shape, it will not be able to bind to oxygen and transport the required amount of oxygen needed in the body. And when that happens, that's why if you see mostly sickle cell patients, they mostly have this crisis. It's as a result of the fact that they have an abnormal hemoglobin molecule. So this hemoglobin molecule is found in the red blood cell. So it's a pigment. It helps to combine to oxygen and helps in the transportation of oxygen in the body. So that is just the function of hemoglobin. So the kind of hemoglobin you have, or the nature or the shape of the kind of hemoglobin that is found in your red blood cell, would then tell you the kind of genotype group you have. So someone with an AA, you have five different types of genotype group. You have someone with the trait AA, and you have someone having AS, you have the SS, you have the AC, and you have the SC. So this SC, it's almost the same like someone having this. AS and SC, they are just the same, but different variant of the trait. When I mean of variant, let me just say like different species. For example, two the same thing, but just like different types, like different species. Like you can quote, for example, a brand of something like this is green, this is blue, but they are the same markers. So that is what I mean by this. So that is just it. So for you to know, like if you are getting married, or if you want to have a baby with someone, you need to check the kind of genotype trait you have. It's very important. Someone having the AA, it's an individual that is normal. This person does not have any trait of sickle cell, meaning this person's hemoglobin structure, it's very normal, it's good, the person has no effect. Someone having the AS is showing this person is carrying a trait. The S stands for a trait of an abnormal hemoglobin, meaning the person is having a trait of sickle cell. Someone having the SS is showing that person has both trait are already abnormal. That person is a sickle cell anemic person. Someone having the AC, like I said already, the AC is another form of trait, and the AS is also another form of trait. The AA is someone that has a normal thread. Someone with a genotype of AS has a single thread that is already signifying this person has a sickle cell trait in them. S is already a carrier of the sickle cell trait. Someone with the SS, it's already a sickle cell anemic person. So that is it. I already explained. That's why it's very important for you to know your genotype group. It's important to know if you are a carrier, if you are a normal person with no trait of sickle cell, or if you are just a carrier, or if you are a sickle cell anemic person. The essence of you knowing it, like at first back in those days, you have some women, they'll give birth to their children, a particular number of them, maybe they might lose some number, and maybe 50% would survive. It can be as a result of this sickle cell trait. So that's why it's very important for you to determine it and know. In case you are someone having the AA trait, let me just take for example a normal individual having the AA trait, get married to another individual having the same AA trait, definitely all their offsprings are going to be healthy individuals with no sickle cell trait. But someone with the AA, which is a normal individual with no sickle cell trait, if the person gets married to someone with an AS having the sickle cell trait in them, let's see how their offsprings are going to be. Let's take for example a healthy individual getting married to someone having the sickle cell trait. This is how their offspring is going to look like. So A will combine with this to give rise to an individual having AA, and A combined with S will give rise to an individual having the sickle cell trait AS, and you have A again combining with E, they'll have AA, and the very last one will be this, which gives rise to a baby that has AS. So in this example, we are going to have four babies, and among the four babies you have two individuals, two offsprings. So these are their offsprings. So for this example, we are going to have two offsprings that are having the sickle cell trait in them, which is this and this. So you see that all of their offspring will be healthy, but among the four offsprings that are healthy, two of them are having the sickle cell trait, while the remaining two, they don't have. So in this situation, if you are a healthy individual, it's good. You can equally get married to anybody, and definitely the babies will all be safe. Your offsprings will all be healthy and safe. But among them, you have 50% chance two will not have the sickle cell trait, and the other 50% will have the sickle cell trait. So let's take for example again a healthy individual who gets married to a sickle cell person. So if you're an healthy individual, and in case you get married to a sickle cell person, it's going to be like this. So you will see the kind of offspring you people are going to have will be AA 18, you have AS. You have AS. The second one will be AS. The next one will be AS again. The last baby will be AS offspring. So in this situation, if a healthy individual get married to a sickle cell patient, you will discover that all of their offsprings are going to have the sickle cell trait in them. But definitely with this, they are normal. at the beginning, these are normal. It's normal. This person is fine. Someone with the AA genotype group has no sickle cell, so they are normal. Someone with the AS, this person only has a single trait of it, so they are equally normal also. For this particular kind of trait, it's very rare. This one is usually very rare. Then this, it's the same as this. This one also, it's normal, but this is the sickle cell trait now. This one is the sickle cell anemia trait. So that is it. So you see, in this situation now, a normal individual getting married to a sickle cell patient, all of their offsprings are going to have the sickle cell trait in them. So let's take for example now, someone getting married. Let me take for example, someone having the sickle cell trait, getting married to a sickle cell individual, what their offsprings are going to look like. So with this kind of a situation, you see they both, these ones, 100% of their offsprings are okay. They only have but the sickle cell trait in them.
Let's take another example.
So now we will take the example of a sickle cell trait getting married to a sickle cell patient. So here we will have the AS getting married to an SS. Let's take a look at how their offsprings are going to be. So in this situation, A combines with S. This is how the genes are going to look like. This one will give another AS. Let me use red for sickle cell. It will be like this. And the last one will be like this. When this gene and this gene combine, it's going to give us sickle cell. So in this situation, someone having the trait needs to be very careful with the kind of person they are getting married to, because someone with this trait, if this person gets married to a sickle cell patient, definitely there is a 50% chance that 50% of their offsprings are going to be sickle cell patient also, and 50% of their offspring are going to have the sickle cell gene in them. So that's why you need to know your genotype group in order to know if your offsprings will survive and or if they will not survive. God. Then let's take another example, like maybe someone with the sickle cell getting married to another person who is a sickle cell patient. Let's take a look what their offsprings are going to be like. So, SS getting married to SS. So you see their offsprings will just be sickle cell here. SS. SS. So let's take a look what they are going to produce. That is why it's very risky for a sickle cell patient to get married to another sickle cell patient. Definitely all their offspring might not survive, because all of them are equally sickle cell patient. They'll give birth to children that are both sickle cell patient. So the general conclusion on checking your genotype is for you to know the kind of sickle cell trait you have, for you to know the kind of hemoglobin structure your red blood cell have. Are you having a normal hemoglobin structure, or are you having the smaller or abnormal or maybe very tiny kind of hemoglobin structure? So that is why it's important you check your genotype, so that once you know your genotype, you'll be able to know. If you are someone who is a healthy individual, then it's good. You can get married to any of this type. Nothing will happen. You can only give birth to a child that has the sickle cell trait. But if you are someone having the sickle cell trait, that's why you need to be very cautious. You need to be very careful with the kind of person you are getting married to. Because if you get married to someone with the sickle cell trait, or someone that is a sickle cell patient, there is a 50% chance that some of your children also will be sickle cell patients. So that's why it's very important. But for someone that is a sickle cell patient, if they equally get married to a sickle cell patient, definitely all their offspring would definitely be having the sickle cell anemia. So that is why it's very important. So if you have been watching right to this extent and you haven't liked, you haven't subscribed, what are you waiting for? Kindly click the subscription button, like, and don't forget to share this video. And one more thing, if you have any question, kindly comment below and definitely I'll be here to answer. And I also did a video regarding the different types of blood group and the different types of Rhesus D factor. So if you are kind of confused, you can also watch. I'll also be dropping a link below so you can equally go there and click and watch directly. So don't forget, I always love you, and remember, stay safe. Ciao.